after a person dies?
It's a beautiful question which should not be answered. You see, if I say that you go to heaven, you just imagine your own heaven, how the heaven will be. If I say you go to hell, you just imagine how hell will be. Both the ways, you try to imagine and project the future. If I just let the question sink in you, just allow this question to become a quest. What happens actually? Whomsoever I ask, they give some answer, but I am not satisfied. What really happens? Just allow the question to sink in you. That's a beautiful way to go inside you, your being. This is the thought. If you really want an answer, if you really want to find a solution, just go inside. You will see that you will find something new experientially which can give you an answer. Otherwise, now I can tell you a beautiful answer. Oh, according to your papa and punya, you go to heaven and hell. That I can tell. Just to cover you, you see, just to satisfy you, but I won't be satisfied. If I tell that answer, I can satisfy you, but not me. I tell you honestly, allow this thought to sink in you. Allow this quest to happen in you. Never answer it. Never take anybody's answer. Don't go and ask some other Swami. Oh, I think Nityananda Swami doesn't know. Let me ask some other Ananda. He will give some answer. Don't take up the answer. Don't read it from any book. Don't accept any answer given from outside. Ask yourself. You see, from somewhere only I came here. Somewhere only I am going to go. If I have come from somewhere, there only I am going to go. It means already I know from where I came. I must know where I am going to go. Why to ask others? Let me see by myself. Have a little bit of courage and ask this, allow that question to haunt you. Mark my words, allow that question to haunt you. You will see a clear clarity arises in you, which nobody will be able to shake.
And relating to that question, relating to the same question that I had, is it necessary, like after a person dies, that they are born to the same world or anywhere in the universe?
That is what, ma'am. You see, now you can say that according to your karma, you take human birth, according to your karma, or you go any other janma. If I say this answer, you will finish this question, over. You will close the book and keep it in your rack. You will never open it again. You take the answer for granted. You think that you have got the answer. You see, if you know that you don't know, at least you know you don't know. If you don't even know that you don't know, you don't even know you don't know. If you don't know that you don't know, you don't even know you don't know. If I give you answer now, you will not know, but you think that you know. You will come to a conclusion that I have got the answer. Now things are clear. Intellectually you close this question and keep it in your book. Alvara, over. You understand? Now, no answer. No question. Just you will allow this question to sink you, haunt you. You will see where this question takes you. Confuse yourself at the most, as much as possible. You will see a tremendous clarity will arise in you, which can never be confused. Then you will know, you know.
Swami, I want to ask you, after we die, is it necessary that they should perform all the rituals? The
30th day
and after 1 year,
you see, ma, that is not necessary for you, but that is necessary for the people who are living. Actually, when we take birth, the father and mother's energy is with us. Their being is with us. When they die, whatever we do, the ritual is not going and reaching them. It is satisfying our own energy, which is in our body, which is in our system. If you don't do that, they will not be, no way they will be disturbed. They will go to the next life and that will go on. Nobody will wait for your rituals, your rites. But your own personality, that's a portion of personality, which will be having the connection with them, will not feel that it is relaxed or rested. Whenever father dies, you will see your right is disturbed. Whenever mother dies, you will see your left is disturbed. whenever a brother dies, you will see the below him portion is what to say, motionless. That will be affected. If your father dies early in the early of your life, you will have, you be sure the possibility to have the right side, that is more. Because yes.
Well, some people have this after death experience that they leave the body and they come back. You same in the body. What is that?
Yes. You see, there is a possibility that gaps are possible. In very rare cases, gaps are possible. If they enter back again to the body, if you ask them, they will be able to recollect in a metaphysical way. You see, they will not be able to recollect physical way. They will recollect in a metaphysical way. A tunnel, sort of a red light, something. A metaphysical way of recollection will be there, which is not true in your sense. You see, when they say it is tunnel, what they mean is totally different. When you understand the word tunnel, what you understand is totally different. So never try to understand metaphysical things from the physical plane. Better, if you want to have an experience, have it by your own meditation. That is the ultimate authentic solution for you.